Joe Rose, who took second at state, and find out what it takes to be an all-star diver. The epic pizza that's sweeping South Kitsap, we ask the hard critics of Portal Drink what they think. And boys will be bros? What is a bromance? We take a look inside the life of bros around South. Find out all this and more.
He still hasn't texted me back yet.
Maybe he's not into you.
No, he's into me. He invited me over for some DJ game.
Oh, DJ Hero? I heard it's pretty cool.
I don't know about cool, but definitely means he's in love with me.
In love, maybe not. But let's watch this video.
It's amazing. I'm the reason everybody fired up this evening. I'm exhausted, barely breathing, holding on to what I believe, and no matter what you
DJ Hero is becoming well known around the video game scene, a game that is similar to Guitar Hero, although instead of a guitar, you use a turntable controller.
This is the DJ Hero controller. Pretty simple, not too big. Over here, depending on if you want to play right-handed, left-handed, left hand the controller will be like this, right hand the controller will be like this. You have your green, red, and blue for buttons you have to press. They'll be in a line of three. You have your table, of course, to where you can spin it, rewind it. Rewind it, scratch it. And down here, you have the cut. Just cut stuff, like eventually it'll tell you to move to the left. Cut it to the left, cut it to the right. And this black button right here is your euphoria button.
Yeah, it's one of the best games ever.
Yeah, actually it's actually better. It's actually better because it's harder. More competition, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, now just...
In this day and age, video games are becoming more and more popular, so companies try and produce more games. The Guitar Hero brand is branching off to appeal to more potential buyers because not everyone likes to play guitar or likes music stereotyped with the guitar.
So amazing, so amazing, it's amazing, so amazing, so amazing, so amazing, it's amazing.
Oh, I like the songs. Good mix of songs. I don't know why, but the songs are just like, I wish I could have mixed those songs together. Makes me want to go out and be a DJ. Maybe I'll be a DJ.
I think it's an expansion of the Guitar Hero brand because it's trying to outreach to more people because not everybody likes guitars.
A lot of people enjoy playing DJ Hero because it's something friends can play when they just hang out. This society we live in now has a lot to do with kids and their friends. Although video games don't promote physical activity, they do promote social activity, which is highly accepted in our society.
I pretty much kill it, like, you know, every day, every time I play it, I just get up in the booth and it just happens, you know? So, you know, I'm a pretty good dancer, as you saw earlier in the video when I was jerking while DJing at the same time, so I like to get down, and this is something I can get down to.
Also really hard
Why are you overanalyzing it? I'm sure not. He'll just be happy that you're playing with him.
I know, but I can't just be good. I have to be great.
Why don't you join dance? Those girls are pretty impressive.
Oh my gosh, I can't dance. I don't. Have you seen those girls? They're amazing. Take a look at this.
I bet you didn't even know that South Kitsap had a dance team, now did you? But not for long. The 2009-2010 dance team has spent the year working their butts off in order to make a name.
We've been working really hard because we really want to make a name for ourselves, not just for South Kitsap, but for the entire state.
Compared to last year's team, skills, attitude, and overall performances have shown how much work has been put in.
Every year there's the same big names at competition. There's Tumwater, Heritage, East Lake.
Our goal this year is to become a big contender at state so we can compete with those really difficult teams and make a new name for ourselves.
That's exactly what the South Kitsap Dance team did. At multiple competitions over the season, South Kitsap Dance has received scores up with those big name teams. And at the 2009 annual Heritage competition, South Kitsap took first.
So at Heritage this year, we did really well. We took first place, and I'm not gonna lie, I bawled like a baby, and it was quite embarrassing, but it was probably one of the best experiences of my life.
This year's team has received more trophies than the past 6 years combined. And I guess the big question is, how is South Dance going to do at state?
At state this year, South Kitsap is going to do really well, and people are going to finally recognize how hard we worked and how we earned our spots.
Hey, you're right. Those girls are pretty good.
Yeah, I know. I can never be that good.
Well, you know what they say, a way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Okay.
Take him out for pizza. Pizza Factory's like right over there.
The Pizza Factory?
Do you live under a rock? Take a look at this.
Where can you find delicious pizza in Port Orchard? That's right, Pizza Factory. And yes, their delicious pizza has a lot of people talking.
Hi, my name is Scott Nelson. I'm the owner of Pizza Factory in Port Orchard, Washington. We've been open for a little over 2 years now, and I moved to our current location here on Mile Hill about 6 months ago. So we love this location. We got to design it all ourselves, and the people love it. We've got bigger game rooms, a big party room that's very popular, and a bigger kitchen, which makes it a lot easier to serve the food quicker. The thing that I enjoy most about it is the people. We love our regular customers. We have a lot of people that come in 3 or 4 times a week. We have our buffets, lunch and dinner, and they love that. It's a great economical way to have lunch or dinner. And the people part of it is just really, really the interesting part. We've made a lot of great friends.
And friends they did make.
So I eat at Pizza Factory 2 or 3 times a week, especially at lunch buffets. And sausage pizza is absolutely my favorite, but these folks are just wonderful for the pizza they produce. The sauce is delicious, the cheese is delicious, and the crust is delicious.
Just delicious.
Yes.
With all the commotion, I wanted to go behind the counter and see it for myself and how it was all made. And yes, you guessed it, they actually really toss them. And you add 5 ounces of sauce. A lot of cheese. Salt to make the pizza not greasy. And any toppings that you so desire. It takes about 7 to 10 minutes to cook. And then, voila, yummy, yummy, yummy pizza. Pizza Factory supports South Kitsap High School tremendously with all their SK pride.
A new location, we're right across the street from the high school, and we've really gotten into sponsoring a lot of things with the high school and as well as a lot of other schools around the South Kitsap School District. It's just been a great time, and we've had a lot of fun. We enjoy supporting those groups and getting involved in the community.
You like it?
Yes.
Yeah. How do you like it? If you don't believe them, go try the pizza out for yourself. I'm sure you'll be honking that horn.
Might work. Pizza Factory sounds really good, actually.
Yeah, so who's this guy you're obsessing over?
Well,
Shh! Sorry. It's not Joe Rose, is it?
No, why didn't you say that?
Well, because we have this really cool video on him. Take a look.
Diving, an art form, a sport, and an uphill battle for all involved. Seen as one of the more elite and difficult sports, diving requires focus, bravery, and natural coordination. Throughout the season, the SK Dive team has been tirelessly trying and succeeding to fight for South's honor.
Okay, I'm Kelvin Waterman. This is my first year diving, and I'm a junior this year. Diving's a hard sport because it takes a lot of mental concentration to do the flips that you have to do in diving. You can't just go up and go for it, or you're gonna hurt yourself. You have to think about what you're doing, think about your turn beforehand, and train your dives a lot.
Joe Rose, a talented and eccentric young diver, has become sort of a symbol for SK's diving.
Hi, I'm Joe Rose. I'm a junior at South Kitsap High School, and I have been diving officially for about a year. And I also go to Frederick Way 2 days a week and dive out there. Dive is the best sport out there. It's better than swimming. Way better than football. Definitely way better than football. Way better than basketball. Way better than wrestling. Definitely better than Quidditch. I love that Quidditch game. That's intense. I just said that.
So if you'd like to try your hand at this sport, come join the swim team next year. It's a lot of fun and a self-fulfilling adventure. But don't forget to bring your game face.
Oh, Russ is pretty impressive.
He's more than impressive.
Whatever. My guy's nothing like you've ever seen before.
What?
Nothing you can compare to your neighborhood.
Are you trying to find the words to describe him?
Without being disrespectful.
Maybe you should start a band.
I should. Or like Malnourished Cat. Josh Wolf is so amazing. He's really talented.
Watch this, guys.
Joshua Schultz, the man. The band. The one-man band. This is Malnourished Cat.
Who here likes music?
The Malnourished Cat is a band created by the one and only Joshua Schultz. Josh is a senior at South Kitsap High School, but instead of having people in his band from the school, he's decided to do it all by himself.
After being in a lot of musical activities, I decided that, I thought inspiration would come easier in a solo setting, so I decided to create Malnourished Cat.
Having a band by yourself can be extremely difficult because you will need a lot of talent to be able to play more than one instrument. Josh, on the other hand, can play over 5 instruments.
My main instruments are piano. It's my number one. I've been playing it the longest. The next one I play most recently right now is guitar, and then percussion.
Malnourished Cat, not being very well known and having kind of a ridiculous name, has done quite a bit of open mics and big shows such as the talent show. But now, since this band has been rising to fame, it has been grabbing a lot of fans.
At first I thought Josh having a one-man band was
kind of arrogant and egotistical, but after listening to his music, I understand that just anybody else but him in that band would only slow him down.
I think it's pretty cool that Josh has a one-man band, as Josh is very talented.
Josh putting all of his talent together is taking full commitment to the rise of his band and is willing to take it to the next level of awesome.
Well, currently I do some open mics at DJ's Music and Bayview Java. I did a couple talent shows at school, and other than that, I've been recording some music, writing my own songs lately. Hopefully I can record a CD, some of my songs on it, and get it out there, and I guess that'd be the first thing to do from here.
So if you ever see the ever so talented Josh Schultz, ask around to see when he has a live open mic or something big that he is planning. Why? Because when you finally see that special talent, you will see Malnourished Cat.
Wow, you're right. He's really, really talented. Seems like everyone's got talent but you.
Oh, thanks. If I can't even impress you, how am I supposed to impress this guy? He's smart, intelligent, brainy, well-read.
So he's smart.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Have you tried Honor Society?
Honors what?
Oh my gosh. Take a look at this.
On a freezing Friday afternoon, a group of students began the daunting task of cleaning up the stream here at South Kitsap. Many people may wonder why they would choose to take on such a project. The stream cleanup here on December 11, 2009 was an organized volunteer event held by South's Honor Society. Many people are unaware what exactly Honor Society does. It's a lot more than simply obtaining a good GPA.
I'm Sean Lormore, and I'm the Vice President of National Honor Society.
And I'm Jessica Duckworth, and I'm the President of Honor Society.
The purpose of Honor Society is it's to give back to the community. It's to it's pretty much a community service organization, so we do different projects and we just do a lot of different things for the community.
In addition to tutoring and the Sinclair Inlet cleanup, Honor Society works to achieve the beautification of SK. It all starts with activities such as this. It's surprising what can be found here in South Creek.
I am Mrs. Stern Stroker, and I am the advisor of the Honor Society. And we've accumulated a whole bunch of stuff like fences and tires and metal pieces and cans and bottles and paper.
Though picking up other people's garbage does not seem like the most exciting task, it does offer a feeling of personal fulfillment. Other than this, there are many beneficial reasons to join Honor Society.
I joined Honor Society to give back to the community and because it looks good on a college application, so.
Yeah, community service is definitely a resume booster, so that's one of the reasons why I joined and to get connected to the community.
If you're interested in becoming a part of Honor Society, please attend the meetings every other Monday in Portable 10 for more information.
Wow, is that a real thing? Can I actually like do that?
Yeah, anybody can, but I think you're gonna need more help than that.
Oh, look, he just texted me. He said, Pizza Factory sounds good, but I have to hang out with my guy friends tonight. What does that even mean?
So you're interested in somebody that's romantically involved with someone else.
Bro what?
He's in a bromance. You know, two guys, a bromance. Watch this video.
Many people have lifelong friends, and on some occasions it becomes more. At that point, the bond is so strong that what was once a friendship is now a bromance. To some people, the idea of a bromance is confusing, so let's explain it.
Just a bunch of guy friends hanging out, having the best time possible. I mean, like, nothing else matches it.
Bromance is some guy, that's like your main man. That's the guy you go to for everything.
What is the difference between a bromance and a romance?
Everything has its pros and cons, except bromances, because bromance is always plus. I mean, like, bros can get in fights about whatever. Like,
"Oh man, you suck at Bejeweled Blitz."
The difference between a bromance and a romance is there's no boundaries in a bromance. I mean, you could talk about whatever you want and no one's gonna get offended.
Oh man, what if this happened? What would we do? Like, what if zombies took over the universe? Like, we would just go around and I'd be like, "Yo, dude, I'd take the auto shoddy."
It probably means even more than a romance, you know?
Romances have always been around, however their name is fairly new. The term has become more and more popular, and there have been movies such as I Love You Man and the TV show Bromance.
Maverick and Goose from Top Gun, you know?
Your eyes anymore when I kiss your lips.
Another famous bromance is on, you know, Superbad between Evan and Seth on there. You know, they're just kind of bros, they went through everything together.
Way too tight. Those are way too tight.
Guys are usually in favor of romances. However, the opinion of girls may be different.
They just have to hang out every day, talk on the phone every day. Even if they're sitting doing nothing, watching football for 5 hours, they still want to be together. This is what he says. He says, "In order for me to be happy, I have to have time with my friends." Like, why wouldn't you want to be with me? Like, wouldn't that make you happy? Like, it just doesn't make sense to me.
After watching this, you may ask yourself, "Did me and my friend have a bromance?" Here are the turning points that show the difference between a bromance and a normal relationship.
If you were to keep a log of how many hours you hung out in the week, I'd say like, what, 20 plus might be a bromance, but it also depends on what you do when you hang out.
To be completely honest, when I'm hanging out with my girlfriend, I'm really just thinking about like what the guys are up to right now.
What kind of foods you choose to go and get together. If you're going and getting Bon Thai or something, you know, you might be a little bit more of a bromance than if you're going and getting Taco Bell.
I can't hang out. I got a lot of homework to do. Okay, yeah, I'll call you later. Yeah. All right, guys, I got my fantasy team.
Yeah! Yeah!
I just want to spread my wings and just be ultra bro and just bro it up all the time.
He's like, "I always need my bro time."
Okay, so I've learned about Honor Society, Pizza Factory, Joe Rose, and bromance.
Yeah, but I still haven't learned who this mystery guy
well,
is.
Well, this is the end of our episode. I'm Caitlin Benson.
And I'm Lauren Dyke. Good morning, South Kitsap. We'll be right back.